So, what are my thoughts on Smashing Pumpkins' Adore? What's going on, ladies and gents of Cyberland? Coming back to you with another album review from the Smashing Pumpkins, and this time we're moving on to Adore is a very different album. Because Adore wasn't the album I bought from the band until way later. I mean, way later in my life. So, even though I was listening to Melancholy during my ninth grade year, Adore had just dropped. And, you know, it was different. I would watch the Ava Adore, I would watch the music video from time to time, and I thought that the song was cool, but it just was different, and something was kind of like, I just felt like something was a little off with this. It just gave me this vibe, like, I don't think this album has anything like the last one at all. And Warehouse was still in business. I believe it was still in business. Or maybe it wasn't Warehouse. Maybe I heard it at Borders. It was either Warehouse or Borders. I listened to the album. I remember I went there for some reason. I don't remember what it was. And I listened to the album and I was not impressed. I listened to some tracks and went through, and I just didn't like what I heard. I was like, where's the guitars? I hear acoustic, but where's the guitars? The drumming doesn't sound right. Where's the instruments that, you know, the band is doing? Little did I know, because I wasn't, like, again, I was listening to Smashing Pumpkins, Melancholy, but I wasn't going into whole about what had happened with the band. So I didn't know that stuff until way later in life. So of course Jimmy Chamberlain was absent and the band was falling apart. You know, it was already, the band was falling apart. So Adore is a great album, but at the time I didn't see it that way, and there's a lot of problems. And it shows in the music. The tracks are not terrible, but it just didn't resonate with me. And for a long time, I would go to all the other stuff before I would go to Adore. And actually, the funny thing is, it wasn't until probably a couple years ago that Adore, I even put the time in to listen to Adore, kid you not. It just didn't interest me. I didn't think it was a good album. There wasn't anything on it that I really wanted to listen to, and I felt it was lacking those things that gravitates me toward the band, is, you know, guitars, bass, and drums. At least where I can hear them. And one day, you know, my kids were doing something, and I just sat down and I listened to it, and I wasn't blown away, but I was wrong about how I felt about it. From top to bottom, it was, I remember I would spend, when I was doing stuff in my kitchen, when I was doing housework and stuff, getting things done inside or outside, and that's when I would listen to it. And it's a different experience. If you're walking in listening to this expecting the first round, you're not going to get that. Sorry. So if that's what you're looking for and that's what you want, then don't bother. But if you're open to listening to something that's different and just gives a more acoustic ballad type of music along with a little techno-ish in it. I don't mean full blast, I mean like low-key techno, like kind of like a low-key Nine Inch Nails, then give it a listen. And I think probably that's what really helped me with listening to albums is because of Nine Inch Nails, because Nine Inch Nails at this point, I love Nine Inch Nails as a kid. And yeah, my rating for them, I would give it 4 out of 5, yes sir. My top, and I think the tracks that made me, the track that really made me pay attention to this more so, I think was Perfect, The Daphne Descends, and Apples Plus Oranges. I think because I saw the turnaround, how the album sounded. Because again, when I first heard it, I was like, what the hell is this? Like, what happened? I just didn't like it. So, yeah, I would say if it's one of those albums you're on the fence about, just listen to it. If it still doesn't resonate with you, it doesn't. I mean, this album's always been, out of the entire catalog, it's always like that split. It's kind of like Linkin Park with 1,000 Suns. It's kind of like the same thing with this. One half loves it, the other half hates it, and then there's some people in the middle that like here and there. And it didn't get the recognition it deserved until way past its due time. It just happened that way. It also was one of the catalyst reasons for why the band broke up with Virgin Records too, because of the support for it. But Virgin Records and Smash Pumpkins always had some issues anyway, and I'll get into that on the key. So, I don't mean to like, normally I'm excited about my top albums, but this one, it's not that I'm not excited, it's just I know so much about everything behind, I know things about the album behind the scenes that it just kind of affected, it kind of affected the music I found. You know when you listen to something and you can feel something, you just get a feeling like something's not right. And that's what I got when I listened to this. I still enjoy it from time to time. It's not one of the albums I was doing on a regular basis, but I know like this was pretty much fun. You know, the house is falling pretty much. We talked about the 3-story house is falling down when you listen to this compared to, you know, Gish, Siamese Dream, and like Siamese Dream started the taking out the base of the house. Melancholy is like where we're in transition to where it's about to break, or it's already starting to come down. And Adore is pretty much the house is falling. At least in the issues with the band and how it correlated into this album. My top 5 tracks is at first, you know, it's funny. Ave Adore is only the only track I would talk about. For a long time, like, that's the only good song on that album. Don't bother the rest. But actually, Apples Plus Oranges is my favorite track. I just love the lyrics and I love the music. I just love how the music goes. Then I would say Ave Adore, Perfect, Daphne Descends, and Pup. It also kind of gives like a folk thing to it, like a folk vibe to that. You like folk music. So with that being said, you know, if you like the other stuff, I would say check it out. Just listen and have an open mind. You could be disappointed. I know I was when I first heard it, but it did grow on me as opposed to the other stuff. So